Today I'm going to talk about when and how to include probiotics in your gut health routine, so stay tuned. Hi there, if you're new here, my name is Amanda Malacheski. I'm a certified functional nutrition health coach and a digestive and allergy detective. For help learning how to repair your digestion, please consider subscribing and be sure to click the bell to be notified when I post a new video. By now you've probably heard that you should use probiotics if you have digestive problems, but how do you know if they're right for you? By the end of today's video, you'll know whether or not probiotics are suggested for your particular situation, and you'll know a little bit more about how and when to use them. Adding probiotics helped my client Angela recover from chronic constipation, and probiotics can help you too, so let's get started. So the very first question we need to answer for you is, do you need probiotics? And here's how I think about this. If you have any kind of digestive symptoms, whether that's diarrhea, constipation, reflux, heartburn, gas, bloating, or anything like that, this is a pretty strong indicator that you have some kind of bacterial imbalance in your digestive system. And probiotics can help this. And there are a lot of other symptoms or conditions that probiotics can help as well. And these include many autoimmune conditions, insomnia, pain, brain fog, anxiety and depression, and many others. In general, probiotics help you balance your gut bacteria, can help repair your gut lining, and can also help you digest your food better. All right, so you have some digestive problems and you think probiotics can help you. So at what point in your digestive healing journey should you include them? So here's how I think about probiotics. I consider them a foundational piece of your digestive support, right alongside an anti-inflammatory diet and basic digestive supports like digestive enzymes and stomach acid support. So if you want to include probiotics in your routine, I recommend first starting with getting your diet dialed in and getting clear on your symptom triggers. And once you've got that dialed in, then you can add in your basic digestive supports, including probiotics, enzymes, and stomach acid support. The reason we want to focus on the diet first is that if you are continuing to eat a diet that is triggering your symptoms or is aggravating your gut microbiome, it's going to be really difficult for the probiotics that you're adding to make much of a difference. And so when you eliminate your food triggers and the things that are aggravating the situation first, it just makes the work that the probiotics are going to do for you that much easier. Now, your next question is probably, how do I use the probiotics? I'm lately recommending the advice that Dr. Michael Ruscio gives in his recent book called Healthy Gut, Healthy You. And this is to use three types of probiotics together. I'll leave a link to his book below this video for you if you want to check that out. Dr. Ruscio claims that despite the hundreds or even thousands of probiotic products on the market, that there's really only three basic categories of probiotics. And these are lactobacillus bifidobacteria blends, beneficial yeasts like Saccharomyces boulardii, and soil-based probiotics. And that when you use all three of these probiotics together, there's a synergistic effect and that they each fill an important role in the gut microecosystem. Now, just to be clear, not everyone's the same and not everyone is going to need all three of these, but if you can tolerate all three of them together, there's the potential for a much better clinical response for you. So here's an example of what this looks like in real life. My client Jenny was already using a Saccharomyces boulardii probiotic, and I recommended to her that she add the other two in and give them a try. And all you can do in this situation is give it a trial and see how your body responds. So she added the lactobifido blend, but that turned out to flare her histamine symptoms. So she couldn't tolerate that one. And so we decided to leave it out. And then she trialed the soil-based probiotics, which worked for her for a while. But then after she had used them for 6 or 8 months, they all of a sudden started triggering bloating. So then we took those back out again. Other clients report feeling really great on all three together. So the key message here is you have to listen to the feedback that your body's giving you and rely on that information when you're making your choices. If you'd like to see the probiotics that I recommend for my clients, you can open an account with my dispensary over at FullScript. I'll leave a link for that below this video, so go check that out. Have you used multiple types of probiotics or had a reaction to probiotics before? Tell me about it in the comments. So that's how to think about when to use probiotics. If you have digestive challenges, include them early in the process. Try to include at least one high-quality product from each category of probiotics and listen to your body's feedback about whether it's working or not. If you're still confused, there's two ways I can help. You can learn more about how to create a good gut healing foundation in my roadmap to gut recovery. In the roadmap, I give you the tools to determine what are the right next steps for you to heal your gut. You can download your free copy of Roadmap to Gut Recovery by visiting confluencenutrition.com/roadmap, and I'll be sure to leave a link for that below this video. Or if you've already tried a lot of different things and you're in a place where you're ready for some more one-on-one customized support, I want to invite you to schedule a free 30-minute consultation with me to find out if working together would be helpful for you. You can schedule your free appointment by visiting confluencenutrition.com/contact and following the instructions there. So I'll look forward to meeting you. So that's all for now. If you have a question that I haven't answered that you'd like me to speak into, please be sure and leave it in the comments. I will get back to you as soon as possible, and I may even turn it into a video. And if you liked this video, please consider liking and sharing it with your friends and family. Take care.